Good morning, happy Tuesday. I just got into my classroom. It is 7:20. I don't know why I cannot see that clock. I swear sometimes it like looks lighter and I cannot read the numbers all the way from here. Anyway, I just got so sidetracked on what I was saying. It is Tuesday and I brought my laminator to school. I usually leave it at home because most of the time I'll just laminate the stuff at home, bring it to school. But in my brain, I thought it'd be a good idea to bring it here because it'd be one less thing to move. It's like such a small box, but like in my brain, it made sense. I needed to laminate stuff, so I figured I'll just bring it to school. And then when we move, if I want to bring it back home, then I can just bring it back home. But I can just laminate stuff here. It's like not a big deal. So I'm making, though, some games. I'm not going to use them today, but they're just stuff that I want to have ready. So we're going to be starting 3-digit place value in our next topic, so like next week. And so I printed these off TPT, and so it has the number form, the expanded form, and the word form. And then I'm gonna laminate them and then have our TAs cut them all out for me into pieces. And I was just thinking that, because I always put like letters on the back side of stuff like this so that they all stay in one like bag, and then the kids know which ones go back together. But I just realized I won't want to put these like that because they're a puzzle and you wouldn't want to know which one goes together. I guess I'll just do one set of yellow and then maybe I'll do one set of a different color and then just have two sets of them. That'll probably work. I think I'll do that. So anyway, I'm going to laminate them. And then I also made some new flow maps yesterday for my reading groups slash like anytime I feel like I want to use them. I saw, I think her name is Naturally Elementary on Instagram. She was going over like her small group area in her classroom in an Instagram story. And she had showed that she had flow maps, but they were laminated, and so she uses them in her groups, but then it's easy because she can just wipe them off and like not doesn't have to waste them, which would be perfect because sometimes I know we can't get through an entire flow map in like one sitting in a guided reading group because guided reading groups are only like 15 to 20 minutes. So she printed them on Astrobites and then just laminated them, and they were super super cute. And I think that's such a good idea because then you're not like wasting them all the time. Like if you only want to fill out one box of the flow map and then be done for the day, you can do that, and then you can either like save it for the next day or just like, you know, erase it and be done. So I'm gonna do that, and I may end up making them for my WIN group as well, my language arts WIN group. We haven't been doing our WIN groups because we've been trying to get DRA testing done, which I am down to I think 3 kids left, which is really good. So I just need to finish those, and then I need to finish report cards, and then I feel like I'll have a lot kind of taken off my plate. We started benchmarks yesterday, so that's another thing. Like benchmarks will be done after today, except for a few of the kids that just need to be made up. But I think that's a lot of stuff that's just like in my brain that will feel nice to just be done. So yeah. Today we have our benchmark this morning, so that'll be all this morning. Our math benchmark yesterday we did language arts, and my kids did better than the first time this year, the first trimester, so that's good. That was kind of all I was hoping for, is at least for, you know, progress. So, or not progress, but I guess growth. And we totally did, so that's awesome. And I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, today we're going to be using our close reading companion from our Wonders book. It's not my favorite in terms of like using it as a close read, but I do think it's a good resource. I just don't use it like it's a close read resource. I use it more as like a comprehension connections type of thing. Yeah. So anyway, I'll catch up with you guys a little bit later. It'll probably be after school because I'm going to get work done this morning. I made sure to get here really early so I could just bust stuff out. So I'll see you guys after school and I'll let you know how my day went and what we did. Hello, it's 3:45, and I just kind of sat down and like got myself situated. This afternoon, I don't even know what I need to do right now. I need to look at my to-do list. I've still been using Google Keep, the app, for like making to-do lists, it's kind of been helping, but I have to like make sure I keep myself up with it or else I'll just like forget. So I've been using that to kind of make to-do lists because it's like always with me because it's on my phone. And then I can easily just like cross stuff out. So it makes it nice. But I need to look at that and then like kind of figure out. I think I have everything ready for tomorrow. No, I don't. I need to make a test. Yes. I don't know why I just heard talking. Anyway. So we took our benchmark today. The math benchmark. And my kids didn't do as well as like the first trimester, but I also kind of expected that because the first trimester one was just like pretty basic. I think it was a fairly easy test, and so my kids did like really well. I had every kid score meet or exceed standard, like every kid in my class, which is like very unheard of. So I don't feel like it was like a super hard test or anything. This time around, I do think it stretched them a little bit more because it did include a lot of the subtraction with regrouping, which we just took the test on that and my kids didn't like do all that well on it. Like we're at the point where we just need more practice. Like we understand the concept, but we just need a lot more practice with it. And it did include quite a few of those questions. So I was definitely happy to see them not do too poorly on the test. I have about 75% of my kids scored met or exceeded, which is, I think, pretty good, considering this was like a harder test. Plus, a lot of the questions were place value to 1,000, and technically we haven't hit on that yet. It's our next topic, and by the time I caught that, I told the assessment office that it wasn't our essential and it shouldn't have been tested yet, and they had already, people had already taken the test, so they couldn't change it at this point. So that's another thing. Like they technically haven't even learned it yet, although it's something that like I think they know. But they technically haven't learned it yet. So that was another thing. Like, yeah. This morning I'll show you what I made. I told you I was gonna make some flow maps. Let me go grab them. Okay, so I made these flow maps, and then to like make it a little bit better, I just double-sided them with something that would also be useful on the backside, so I could get like more bang for my buck basically with my Astrobites paper and my lamination. So the front side is just a flow map, and so it's I read a story about whatever at first, next, then last, and then there's a line at the bottom. Sometimes I have them do like a closing sentence for it, and then on the back side we do like main topic, main idea, details a lot. So we have the main topic goes at the top, the main idea of the story, and then the three details to support that. And then I found this thing on TBT and I just inputted the picture, but it's a retell versus a summary and the differences between the two, because it's kind of a big deal when you're doing DRA tests, because when they're doing a DRA test, a retell is really, really important until they get to higher levels, and then they don't want a retell, they want a summary where they're only including like the most important information. So I want them to kind of be aware of the difference between the two. I thought these were really awesome and I'm super excited to use them. The only thing is I don't have like the small dry erase markers, and so it's going to be hard to write in them. We only have like the big ones. So I asked the office if they have, because I've never seen them give us the little ones, so I kind of think that we only order big ones, which means I may just like, I have some little ones, but I'm running pretty low. They're from like 2 school years ago. And so they're not going to be like good enough for them. So I don't know, maybe I might end up just like purchasing some little ones. Cause I only have the big ones, cause we have our whiteboard table. So we have like tons of whiteboard markers, but we just don't have any little whiteboard markers. And these are definitely not going to be working with the big ones. So I need to figure that out. That's my only dilemma. So yeah, I really liked that idea though, because then I don't waste paper, and I think the Astrobites kind of makes it a little bit cuter, and I don't know, they might have more fun like writing on the colored paper rather than just like a normal piece of paper, and then I'll have to waste the paper all the time because it, I mean, I'm not going to like do anything with it necessarily. It's like practice at my table or whatever. So yeah. What else did we do today? The math test took us a whole lot longer than I thought it would. We were working on it from the time we got to school until 11:30. I mean, we had a recess in between there, but 11:30. So that was that. And then we used our Close Reading Companion, which goes with our Wonders curriculum. And we just answered some questions in here and kind of like dug deep with one of the texts a little bit. And that was pretty much it. And then we went to lunch. And after lunch, they did literacy centers. They worked on that for a while. And I was able to finish my DRA testing. I just need to go back through and grade a couple of the ones that are the writing tests. So with DRAs, they start doing their own, like they retell the story up until level, I think it's a 24. And then after 24, so 28 and above, they actually get like a sheet of paper or a form that they have to fill out. And it's like a summary. And it basically says like first, next, then last, basically. And so they have to go. So that's why it's like a difference between like retelling me the story versus now, okay, you have to write down and it's a summary because you need to pick out the five most important parts and put them in order. But those ones take me longer. So the rest of them I live graded in front of the kids. We graded it together and we talked about like where they were lacking. And then these ones, I'm going to have to grade them and then go over them with the kids because it takes me too long. Like some of them I haven't read the book yet, so I have to go back through, or it's been a while. I need to go back through and like read the book and remember what it was about. So that's that. I think that's about it. We got the room all cleaned up. There's just like a few things that I need to put away. And then I need to figure out what I'm doing. I have to make a couple of phone calls. And I think that's it. And then I'm gonna go to the gym. So I'll catch up with you guys before I go and let you know if I did anything worth sharing. Okay, so I am just cleaning up some last minute things. And I'm going to head out. I'm starting to get kind of a headache. I don't know why in my head. Like, lately I keep getting like a little headache for a very short amount of time and then it goes away and then it's done, but I don't know what's like causing it to happen. It's really, really annoying. But anyway, so my head doesn't feel very good and I still am gonna go to the gym and I have to run to the store to get some milk so I can make for the cornbread that goes like on top of the dish that I'm gonna make tonight. I'm making like a casserole dish, but it needs cornbread on the top and you need milk. And we never have milk in our house because neither of us drink milk. We don't like milk. So because of that, I have to go get like a little tiny thing of milk. I hate, like, I wish you could just mix water or something in it, but you can't. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I'll show you my outfit really quick and then I'm gonna go change and head home. So today was Wear Stripes Day because we're doing like dress up days for Dr. Seuss all throughout this week. And oh, my table's like a mess. So I have on a striped like t-shirt and then I just have this green like army kind of jacket, trench coat thing on the bottom, and then just some jeans and my brown boots. I love wearing this jacket because it's got huge pockets, and by the time I get home every day, like if I've worn it, my pockets are just like full of school stuff. Like, actually, no, I did pretty good today. I've got Vaseline, lip gloss, purple flare pen, pinkish, orangish flare pen, dry erase marker. Yeah, that was it. Normally I'll have like 8 dry erase markers in my pockets, so nothing much today, but I'm gonna get to work early tomorrow. Actually, it was really nice. I got to work like really early this morning, like to the point where I had to go through the gate to get in because nobody was in the office yet, but I really liked it because I got a lot of stuff done this morning, so I'm gonna try and do that again tomorrow morning, because I'm just like more productive in the morning. I didn't used to be like that, but I don't know why lately. I think it's because when I know I need to leave, I'm just like, I haven't been very productive in the afternoons. Just because I can't like figure out what I even need to do by the time school's over with. So yeah, got my assessment made for tomorrow. They are going to my math group. We switched around our WIN groups. So I'm going to give them a pre-assessment to see what they know. And then this is what I'll be covering in the next couple weeks. My group is going to be working on word problems with subtraction. So I'm going to do single step and double step word problems. So I've got two questions that are just basic, like double digit word problems with subtraction. And then I've got three two-step word problems that have subtraction, and I just like literally cut and pasted stuff onto this thing, and then I'm just gonna go make copies of it. It was just easier to do it that way, because sometimes word problems are kind of hard to create, especially the double digit or the two-step ones. It was easier just to take them from like our curriculum, which I'm gonna have to figure out what I'm gonna practice with the kids, actually, now that I think about that. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do tomorrow with them. And then I printed Invaders of the Ecosystem. It'll be our close read for tomorrow. And we've already had this plan for a while, and it's one that I actually watched my principal do that article in my class last year for a close read. She was just like modeling it for me, and so that was the article she used, and it's a really good one. And then we used it when we planned a close read with like Artosas and stuff. I don't remember who was even there. It was like people, I don't know, like people outside of our district that come and like train us on close reading. Yeah. So anyway, that's for tomorrow. So I'm going to actually just end off the vlog here because I don't think I really have anything else for tonight. And it's kind of already getting a little bit long. So I will see you guys tomorrow. And I think that's it. So if you haven't already subscribed, make sure you subscribe and make sure you hit the thumbs up button. And I will see you guys tomorrow. I was thinking today was Wednesday and tomorrow was going to be Thursday. And then I realized today's only Tuesday. But it's been a pretty good week so far, so it's going by like medium. Not super fast and not super slow, so yeah. Alright, I'll see you guys tomorrow on Wednesday.